Once upon a time, a sister gave her brother his letter of Hogwarts in a sunny day on a beach. He was opening his chamber of secrets. The boy's brother gave him, some days later, a philosopher's stone. The young wizard read that stone until he lost track of time. He found true friendship in other young witches and wizards, doing all sorts of spells and sorcery with them. When he became an adult wizard, magic was always around him. Like when his cat Dumbledore used Arresto Momentum, jumping from the 16th floor. He followed his call for the next adventure. Fate brought him to the place where the author of the story he loved so much walked many years ago. It is an ancient city filled with magic. And then, another letter called him to become a free walking tour guide. His curiosity led him on a quest. The quest led him to a labyrinth of time and stories. And in the center of that labyrinth, locked in the safe 713, he found a treasure, a parchment entitled Harry Potter and City of Potter. Then, the world was cursed by a dark magic, locking everyone inside their home. The wizard was sad, until an idea was given to him, and he transfigured his scroll into a computer. When the curse was lifted, people returned to the streets. One day, the wizard went to speak to the company he worked with and found himself locked out on the street. He knocked and called for someone, and two squibs that somehow got hold of a wand used the spell Silencio on him. The wizard knew there was nothing to do, but he didn't accept that treatment. He used the spell Sonorous, for no one should be silenced and abused in a work relationship. The wizard was told that he'd need luck to heal his traumas. The wizard politely replied to the squibs that his scroll was protected by the Guild of Portuguese Authors and their powerful spells. And the squibs got furious at him for daring registering his work. True magic is about passion and understanding. It's felt in our hearts, for it is about transformation. Something as simple as opening a children's book. Billions of lives, like mine, have been transformed by the story of the boy who lived. It is J.K. Rowling's testimony against betrayal, falsehood, and abuse. The values of this story are friendship, uniqueness, and that where we come from does not define us, but our choices. And above all, the power of love, for love is victory over death.